The improvements we are going to see for the SVG export filter was all about the exporting the background of a slide. The first topics about be able to export a slide that owns a custom background. In fact, one of the features of the BuyImpress is the ability to set a custom background for a slide instead of using the background of the master page linked to the slide. This feature was not working since the JavaScript presentation engine shown always the master page background instead. The one used as custom background. I suppose you are familiar with the basic code, the SVG markup language. Anyway, I want to remind you the use element. This use element allows to reuse more than once an artwork, in this case a simple rectangle, allowing to change its geometry and style feature. So we can define an object just once and use it many times. And that is the use element is exactly what is used for getting a single master page rendered in each slide. Anyway, the master page is not referenced directly by a use element because a master page has some content that is customized by each slide or even generated dynamically, such as a slide number, date, time, or a slide that owns a custom footer. When a slide needs to be rendered, the JavaScript presentation engine creates a group of use elements referencing sub-object of the master page instead of the whole master page. In order to create this group of a sub-object referenced, there is a specific class named the master page view. What we are interested in this case is the first use element that reference the master page background. In order to get a custom background exported correctly, we need to modify this class in order to make it aware that the slide owns a custom background, so that instead of referencing when it creates that use element, the background, the master page, it references the custom background. The master page view class for creating this structure needs some metadata information about the slide. This metadata information is represented by the slide number and the visibility of the several text fields that made up the master page, and even other kind of information. The metadata is exported as custom attributes, all with a prefixed triple namespace. In the example below, you can see, for instance, the master custom attribute that specify what is the ID with which the master page related to this slide is exported. In order to make the master page view aware that a slide is using a custom background, we have introduced a new attribute named as custom background. The generate metadata method that export this group of metadata information checks if the field style property for a background slide is different from field style none, and in that case append to the group element a new attribute that you can see in the example below in red. In this way, the metadata, the meta slide class that is responsible for parsing in the JavaScript presentation engine all these attributes and transforming them in properties of the instance of the meta slide class itself, is able to provide information to the master page view class so that it can know if a slide is using a custom background and then referencing the ID of the custom background instead of the ID of the master page background in the use element we have seen in the previous structure. So getting custom background working, the second step is provide the ability to use a bitmap as background. Now, exporting a bitmap as background was disabled as a workaround because the same bitmap was exported many times. That occurred not only when the same bitmap was used as a custom background for several slides, but also when a bitmap was used as a tile. In that case, the same bitmap was exported as many times as was the number of tiles. Obviously, that led to an exported SVG document, very huge, and the slide rendering in the browser was horrible. In order to solve this problem, we have modified the create object from background method of the SVG filter class. This method, in order to export the background of a slide or a master page, use it to create a GDI meta file for the object that made up the background of the slide. This meta file then is passed to an instance of the SVG writer for converting each meta action in one or more SVG element so that the background gets exported. We have added a new task to this method. The method iterates on the meta action present in the meta file and collects all meta action related to bitmaps. And use it for creating a map whose key is the checksum of the bitmap embedded in the meta action. The checksum is dependent from the bitmap position, so we have a single map entry per each bitmap. Once we have collected all these meta action related to bitmaps, we can exporting image element related image element that represent the bitmaps. We have implemented a specific method named impl export background bitmaps. This method iterates over all the bitmap action present inside the map we have populated earlier. And for each entry in the map, it creates an image element. The image element then is referenced is referenced by one or more use elements at the place where the custom background for a slide is defined, or more than once, even for the same slide. In the case, the image is a tile. In this fragment, you can see a slide whose background is a tile at the background, And as you can see, the use element exported is the use element exported are more than once and all reference to the same bitmap. This occurs inside the write BMP method or the SVG action writer class, which usually and is the default handler for bitmap meta actions. The bitmap is passed to this method and then is exported as an image element. We have modified it to compute the checksum of the passed bitmap. And in case this checksum is present inside the map, export instead of the image element a use element with a transform attribute in order to set up the bitmap to the appropriate position size, and the href attribute set to an ID that contains the just computed checksum of the bitmap. That's is the way we get bitmap used for custom slide background or for tiled background exported only once and then rendered correctly by the JavaScript presentation engine. No modification to the JavaScript presentation engine has been necessary. This solution was a big improvement, but still present some problem for the tiled background case. The problem is that when the use element exported are a large number, it's expensive for the browser rendering them. So if a tiled background has a large amount of tiles, as it occurs for background of type pattern or edges, we end up with having many tiles because these tiles are very small. The result is that the browser can need 1 or 2 minutes for rendering a slide. In order to solve this problem, we have used the SVG pattern element. The pattern element allows to define some object, some artwork, that then is used as a tile for filling some shape. In this case, you can see a simple example where a pattern is made up by 2 lines, one red, one green, and is used for filling a rectangle. Note that the fill attribute is a reference to the pattern by specifying the pattern ID. The other attribute of the pattern, such as width, are obviously the size of the tile that is going to be used for filling. And the X and epsilon attribute are instead the offset of the tile with respect to the top left of the bounding box of the shape that is going to be filled. This pattern element is exactly what we needed for rendering, for exporting correctly in tiled background. And now there is some details how that occurs. We modified further the create object from background method that now not only called the bitmap meta action as in the previous case, but also looks if we are the background type is a tiled background. In that case, it modify the GDI metafile created from the objects that made up the background by replacing any bitmap meta action related to tiles by a single comment action. This comment action has a special starting tag that, as you can see, is slide underscore background, and then a parameter. This parameter is an ID, exactly the ID of the rectangle you have seen earlier. That is, the idea is the following. We define a pattern that whose content is the bitmap. And then we define a rectangle with the size of the slide, which is filled using that pattern. So when we export, we substitute the meta action related to tiles by this comment action, the ID passed as a parameter to inside this comment is the ID of the rectangle filled by the pattern represented by a bitmap. In order to create, to be able to create exporting the pattern and the rectangle element, we need to collect some data. This data is represented by the structure you can see at the bottom of the slide, and is the bitmap checksum. That is the bitmap that is used for as a content of the pattern, the position that is the offset of the tile, the size of the tile, and then the size of the slide that is used for define the size of the rectangle. All this information is collected in a map, whose key is the ID of the slide which has a tile background. At the second stage, we're exporting all the pattern and rect element, as you can see in the example below. By iterating over this map, and we use the information that we have collected for set up correctly the pattern attribute and the rectangle attribute, that is in the end the width and height. The content of the pattern is a use element, which is referring to the bitmap represented the tile, which has exactly the checksum we have collected at the previous stage. And exactly the checksum of the first bitmap meta action of the bitmap action represented the first tile. Once we have exported this pattern rectangle element, finally we are able to use it for defining the background of the slide. In the write actions method, when a comment meta action is hit, we check if it starts by the slide background tag, and in that case, we create a use element referring to the element having the ID passed as a parameter inside the comment. As I told, this ID is the ID of the rectangle filled with the pattern. And since we have replaced all the meta action related to tiles with this meta action comment, the use element is exported exactly where all that meta action bitmap representing tiles will be exported. That is exactly where will be exported the background of the slide. You can see now that where we have several use elements exported, we have each use element was referring to an image element, that is to a bitmap. We have a single use element referring to the rectangle. And that is the way we have solved the performance issues with tiled background. So these are some small improvement for SVG filter that anyway can be appreciated to who create a presentation. That's all from me. I thank you for listening.